Hey friends, welcome to the YouTube channel All About Electronics. So in this video, we will learn about the flash ADC, which is also known as parallel ADC. So this flash ADC is fastest among all other ADCs. And if you see the typical block diagram of this flash ADC, then it will look like this. So it consists of the high speed comparators, the resistive voltage divider circuit, as well as the encoder. So if you see the AND bit flash ADC, then it consists of total 2 to the power n minus 1 comparators. And if you see the resistive voltage divider circuit of that AND bit flash ADC, then it consists of total 2 to the power n resistors. And here, to understand the working, we will take the example of a 3 bit flash ADC. So this 3 bit flash ADC consists of 7 comparators, and the voltage divider circuit consists of 8 resistors. And as you can see, the input voltage is applied to the positive terminal of the comparators. And through this voltage divider circuit, the reference voltage is applied to the negative terminals. So let's say, if V1 is the voltage to the first comparator, then this V1 can be given as R divided by R plus 7R times V reference. That is equal to V reference by 8. Similarly, if you see the reference voltage for the second comparator, then the V2 will be equal to R plus R divided by 8R times V reference. That is equal to 2 by 8 times V reference. And likewise, if you see the reference voltage for the seventh comparator, then the V7 will be equal to 7 by 8 times V reference. So as you can see over here, there is a difference of 1 LSB between each reference voltage. Because over here, the value of 1 LSB is equal to V reference by 8. So each comparator compares the input voltage with the reference voltage. And if the input voltage is greater than the reference voltage, then the output of that particular comparator will become high. And if that is not the case, then it will remain low. So based on the comparator outputs, this encoder gives the binary code. So those of you who are not aware about the encoder, then it is the combinational circuit which has total 2 to the power n inputs. And at any given time, if only one input is high, then it gives the n bit of binary code corresponding to that input. So for example, if the second input is high, then this encoder gives the binary code corresponding to the second input. But in this encoder, if more than one inputs are high simultaneously, then there is an ambiguity in the output. And for that, the priority encoder can be used. So this priority encoder is a logic circuit in which if two or more inputs are high simultaneously, then it gives the output code corresponding to the highest priority input. And this priority to the inputs can be given either in the ascending or the descending order. So let's say we have set the priority such that the first input has the least priority and the 2 to the power nth input has the highest priority. And in that case, if input 1, 2 and 3 are high simultaneously, then the encoder gives the output binary code corresponding to the third input. On the other end, if input 3 and 4 are high simultaneously, then the encoder gives the binary code corresponding to the fourth input. So to further understand the working of this 3-bit flash ADC, let us assume that the reference voltage over here is 8 volt and the input to this flash ADC is equal to 3.3 volt. Now with this reference voltage of 8 volt, the value of V1, that is the reference voltage for the first comparator, will be equal to 8 volt multiplied by R divided by R plus 7R, that is equal to 1 volt. And similarly, the value of V2 will be equal to 2 volt, and likewise the value of V7 will be equal to 7 volt. So now, the input voltage will get compared with all these reference voltages using these comparators. So in this case, for the input of 3.3 volt, the output of the first three comparators will be high, while the output of the remaining comparators will be low, because if you see over here, the reference voltage for the first three comparators are 1 volt, 2 volt and 3 volt. And as they are less than 3.3 volt, so the output of the first three comparators will be high. And output of all these comparators is given as an input to the priority encoder. Now ideally, there should be 8 inputs to this encoder. But here there are only 7 inputs. So here, the remaining input is connected to the logic 1 and it is set to the lowest priority. That means if all the comparator outputs are low, in that case, the output code of this encoder should be all zeros. So now, for the input of 3.3 volt, here the output of comparator 1, 2 and 3 is high. And as the priority is given in the descending order, so the encoder gives the binary code corresponding to the third input. On the other end, if the input is 6.3 volt, in that case, the output of the first six comparators will be high. And in that case, the encoder gives the binary code corresponding to the sixth input. So in this way, the input voltage is converted into the binary code. Now during the conversion, the input to this comparator should remain constant. Because if it changes, then the output of the comparator will also change. And due to that, the binary code at the output will also change. So to avoid that, the sample and hold circuit should be used along with this ADC. So this sample and hold circuit samples the input signal and it holds that signal until the conversion gets completed. So in this way, in flash ADC, as all the comparators compares the input simultaneously, so it is also known as the parallel ADC. And due to the parallel conversion, it is fastest among all other ADCs. And if you see the commercially available flash ADCs, then they can convert the signal at the rate of gigasamples per second. So basically, these ADCs are suitable for the large bandwidth applications, such as satellite communication, radar processing, and the fast data acquisition for the oscilloscopes. But if you see these ADCs, they consume more power than the other ADCs. And also they have a limited resolution, typically up to 8 bits. Because in this ADC, for a n bit conversion, it requires total 2 to the power n minus 1 comparators. That means for the 8 bit ADC, it requires 255 comparators. So due to that, as the number of bits increases, then the die size will increase exponentially. And due to that, the cost of this ADC will also increase. Apart from that, to provide the accurate reference voltage to the comparators, the resistors in the voltage divider should match accurately. And as the number of bits increases, then the required accuracy of the resistors will also increase. So basically, these are the few limitations of this flash ADC. But in applications, if you require a good conversion speed at high resolution, or for the same resolution, if you require a less die size and a low power consumption, then the half-flash ADC or the sub-ranging ADC can be used. So this is the basic schematic of this half-flash ADC. And as you can see, for the 8-bit conversion, it requires 2 4-bit flash ADCs and 1 4-bit DAC. So in this ADC, first of all, the input signal is sampled using the sample and hold circuit. And the sampled signal is given to the first ADC. So basically, this first ADC is a coarse ADC. So this ADC converts the input signal into the 4-bit digital code. And in fact, this 4-bit digital code is the 4 most significant bits of the final code. So these 4 bits of this ADC is also given to the 4-bit DAC. And this DAC converts these 4 bits into the analog voltage. So this analog voltage is subtracted from the input signal and the difference signal is applied as an input to the second flash ADC. And it converts the difference signal into the 4-bit code. In fact, this 4-bit code is the 4 least significant bits of the final code. So once this conversion gets completed, we will get the 8-bit at the final output. So in this way, by using these 2 4-bit flash ADCs and 1 DAC, the input signal is converted into the 8-bit output. But instead of this half-flash ADC, suppose if we use the 8-bit flash ADC, then it requires total 255 comparators. On the other end, this 8-bit half-flash ADC requires only 30 comparators. So due to that, the die size as well as the power consumption will reduce. But the conversion speed of this half-flash ADC would be slower than the flash ADC. So in short, this modified version of the flash ADC can be used in the applications where the low power consumption and the less die size is required. Of course, these ADCs are not as fast as the flash ADCs, but as they are using the flash ADCs during the conversion, so their conversion speed is faster compared to the other ADCs. So that's it for this video, and I hope in this video you understood the working of the flash as well as the half-flash ADCs. So if you have any question or suggestion, do let me know here in the comment section below. If you like this video, hit the like button and subscribe the channel for more such videos.